$100 Sephora haul. Also ignore the pouring rain and thunder. First, I finally caved and bought the One Size Setting Spray. I have been wanting this spray for so long, but I just like could never bring myself to spend the money on it. But I know I'm not gonna regret this. I know everyone loves this, and I'm so excited to add this to my kit. Next up, I bought the Buxom Gloss in the shade White Russian. This is a plumping gloss, and it's such a stunning shade. I'm gonna add it to my makeup kit and also use it on myself because I think I'll love it. This was an impulse purchase, and it was literally so expensive. Why is this lip gloss like $30? The last thing I got is a restock of Cinema Secrets. This is an instant brush cleaner that so many makeup artists use to clean out brushes in between clients, and I didn't know they sold this at Sephora. I saw it and I was dumbfounded, so I just picked it up, and I like the lemon scented one. That's everything I got. Three things for $96, but I don't regret it.
I have yet another massive Sephora haul. Okay, this is like full, so let's get into it. Okay, starting off, we have this Way Better Together set. I love Way so much, and this is such a good deal. This came with the detox shampoo and the leave-in conditioner, and I already have a leave-in conditioner, but now I have two. Next, I got the big size from my friend, actually, of the Daisy Love Marc Jacobs. This is just in the absolute prettiest packaging ever. Like, oh, look at it. Okay, keeping up with perfumes, I wasn't sure if I wanted to get the big one of this. It's the Good Girl perfume. This is like the mini. It was only $19. And it's in this little high heel shape. It's so cute. And this actually just smells heavenly, and it's so cute. Next, to match the perfume, I got the Daisy Love Marc Jacobs lotion. And then I got this Holiday Tarte set. In this set, there are four mascaras. Okay, actually take it back. There's one eyeliner, which is the Double Take eyeliner. We have the Tubing Mascara, a Big Ego Mascara, and then this 4-in-1 Lights, Camera, Action. This had a 101 value, and it was only $44. And next is my first refill of this Gisu hair perfume. I love this stuff so much. Oh, it's so pretty, and it smells heavenly. Like, I use this, and my hair smells so good for, like, days on end. And that's all. Follow from our hauls.
To Sephora for literally one item and came out with two bags worth, so let's do a haul. They had so many good new things, I just could not help myself. So first thing, if I see one more person rave about this, the One Size pink setting powder. Everyone makes it seem like this is the best under eye setting powder. It's like actually pink. It's supposed to be really brightening, so I'm gonna try it out for myself. I have high hopes. Also had to get this Kosas Dream Beam, another product that I have seen everyone talk about and hype up. Really, I just fall for all the viral products, but it's a sunscreen. Very cute packaging, supposed to be glowy. I'm kind of a sunscreen snob, so I'll be the judge of this. We'll see. Okay, Fenty Summer Collection sucked me in like shapewear. I have not seen this yet, and like look at this packaging. How beautiful is that? So this is their Poutsicle little lip stain, and the shade is Fuchsia Wife. It's like a really bright pinky purple. Also got suckered into one of these new Dior blushes. Now I have always said I don't think that pink Dior blush is really worth the hype. I really don't, but they came out with new shades, and I believe there's supposed to be a new formula. So this one is cherry, and that actually looks really pretty, but we'll see if this one is actually worth the hype because these are not cheap, so they better be good. Okay, what I actually went there for, which is a backup of my Fenty Beauty Eavesdrop, this one I got it in like a more summery sort of shade because the other shade I have this in is a little bit too light for the summer. Okay, also, as if I need any more blushes, these Makeup by Mario blushes have just taken over me. I got the pink one initially, loved it, so I got two more shades. This one is Barely Blushing, very much neutral vibes, which I like sometimes. And then for a more fun sort of pop, I got this one in Just Peachy. How pretty is that for summer? Perfect. And last but not least, Fenty Beauty Gloss Bomb Heat. In the shade Hot Cherry, love a good little cherry gloss moment. And that's everything. Bye.
I know I have a problem, but hear me out. I had 20% off, and this is the only time I buy from Sephora, so I try to buy everything on my wish list. So let's do a haul. The main reason why I went back is because of this holiday lip kit. It values for $127 and it was $45 and then 20% on top of that. Like, this is a freaking feel. And there's three full sizes, like, come on. When I was there, I was like, you know, this is a perfect time to go Christmas shopping. So I picked up another one and I was like, you know, while I'm here, let's pick up a couple more items on my wish list. So I got the Patrick Ta cream contour and bronzer in the shade She Sculpted for medium skin tones. And this shade was out of stock when I first visited, so I had to get her since she was in stock. And then I really wanted the brush for it, but they've been out of stock forever, so I just settled for the small one. And every girly on TikTok has been raving about this lip gloss, so I had to try it out for myself. This is the Tower 28 lip jelly in the shade Cashew. And while I was checking out, I saw this gift set. This is the Tower 28 lip duo in cookie butter. And you know how I said I wanted the House Labs concealer? Well, they didn't have my shade online as well. I settled for a shade for my under eyes. And I've been wanting to try the Huda Beauty setting powder, so I got her in the shade Banana Bread. Cherry Blossom is what I really wanted, but they're out of stock everywhere. And last item while I was checking out, I got a hand sanitizer from Touchland in Berry Bliss. My favorite hand sanitizers ever.
If you've been on TikTok in the last week, you know the Sephora sale is currently going on, so here's a haul of everything I got. Gave me one of the giant bags, so that's how you know it's gonna be a good haul. Almost everything I got is makeup, but I did pick up one hair product. This is the Crown of Air finishing gel. I've heard such good things about this for like slick back, so I had to give it a try. My birthday's coming up in November, so this is the birthday gift I chose. It's just the Patrick Ta one. It comes with a brow laminator and a lip gloss. Also from Patrick Ta, I grabbed this Major Dimension 3 matte eyeshadow palette. And I also grabbed a few face products. I grabbed two of the little blush duos in She's a Doll and She's That Girl. And the, what is this? The Major Sculpt in She's Bronzed. Next, I grabbed this Say Blush Trio. I love these colors. And I actually have this one on right now. And the formula is really pretty. I grabbed two new highlighters. This is the Benefit Tickle Highlighter. And it's this gorgeous, like, pinky shade. And then I grabbed the Anastasia Sun Idol one. It's brand new and people are saying it's very similar to the Amorezi one. I grabbed a bunch of face products, starting with the One Size Ultimate Setting Powder in Ultra Pink. I grabbed the YSL Bare Look Skin Tint. I tried this the other day and the finish was beautiful. For concealers, I grabbed the Hourglass Vanish Concealer and then the YSL Positive Light Under Eye Brightener. And then I also got the new Kosas Glow Ivy in the shade Boost. I had to get the new Summer Fridays lip balm in the mint scent. And then I also got this Afterglow Liquid Blush from NARS in the shade Brazen. I have like the lilac one and it's so pretty on. I got this Refi Brow Tint. I do have the brow sculpt and I love it, so I wanted to get the one with some tint. I got the Urban Decay Moondust Sparkly Eyeshadow. I have a few of these, but I love this color. It's in Cosmic Craze, and it's a little bit more of like a pinky color. And then I just got this Milk Makeup little bronzing stick. And then I just got a new beauty blender to replace my old one.
We just came from Sephora. So today's the last day of the sale. I know what you're thinking. Girl, they did not have no bigger bag. Here's my haul. Fenty Butter Drop. You guys already know this. If you don't have this in your cart, go ahead and add it right now because today's the last day. This is the Danessa Myrick Dynamic Chrome Duo. I had to get this. So I had to get the Netty Vanilla Fragrance as a gift. One of my homegirls been talking about this vanilla fragrance, so I decided to get it. I really wanted to try the Fresh Pink Lip Duo by Charlotte Tilbury, so I got that. Girl, you know I had to. Y'all know I love Donna Bonaroma, so I had to re-up on this one. The Fenty Butter Gloss. This is the Sephora Vitamin E Serum. I got the Sephora Collection Retractable Eyeliner, and this is in the shade 26. So I got the Inculus Lip Plumping Balm. Now, I really want to try this because it's a lip plumper. I got the One Size Setting Spray. Beyonce was singing in the rain, and her makeup did not move. They said that she was wearing this setting spray, so I had to grab it. I had to get the One Size Secure the Sweat. I had to re-up on my Lancome foundation. This is literally in my top three foundations. I love this foundation. I've been wearing it for years. Kyra O'Monique was talking about this lip plumper, so I had to try it by Dr. Dennis Grove. I got the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Cream. I re-upped on my Micro Smooth Powder, and then I got the Clean Reserve Skin Travel Spray. Now, this is my first Clean Reserve fragrance, so I decided to go with the Travel Spray just in case I don't like it. And then I got Bubble Bath by Replica. All the girls been talking about Bubble Bath, and I finally decided to get the Travel Spray. So that was my Sephora haul. Be sure to go ahead and shop the sale. Today's the last day. If you want any links to these products, I'll have them in my Instagram stories.
Sephora package just came in. I'm gonna show you guys what I got from the sale. I think I went a little bit overboard. First off, I got the jumbo size of the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless, whatever, the setting spray, okay? We all know it. Look how huge this is. Next, we got the Drunk Elephant Goldie Drops. This was kind of unnecessary, but like, I just love the glow that it gives some people. Oh my God. I feel like especially because I'm pale now, this will be perfect instead of the bronzy drops. I am so excited for this one. This is the Refi Brow Sculpt. This one has the glue and then it has like the little brush. This is the, are you kidding? It's literally the size smaller than my pinky finger. This is the Rare Beauty Mini Blush in the shade Hope. Next, this is the Fenty Skin Blemish Defeater. It's basically something where you can put over open acne and then put makeup over it and then it literally peels off. It's like so cool. I want to try it. You guys know how much I'm obsessed with Sol de Janeiro 62. Had to get the leave-in conditioner. Got the Sephora Favorites Holiday Lip Kit. I'm gonna do a separate haul on what's inside this, but I'm so excited. Probably the item I was most excited for, this is the Patrick Ta contour thing. I just needed to get my hands on it ASAP because I've been seeing it everywhere. The packaging. Okay, the packaging is everything. Let's look inside. You're lying. So it comes with the cream and the powder, and this is in the shade She Sculpted. Obviously, I had to get the brush with it. This is called the Dual-Ended Sculpting Brush. I love how it has like those protector things on it. Literally the softest thing ever. Then this is the Tower 28 Daily Barrier Recovery Cream. So excited for this. You guys know how much I love the SOS spray from Tower 28, right? So I just had to do it. This is literally massive. Then I had to re-up on my Merit Instant Skin Serum. I already had this, already tried it, already love it, and I had to get another one. This is also another re-up of mine, the Kosas Plump and Juicy Spray. So excited for this. This is the Tower 28 Swipe Concealer. Hopefully this shade matches because I shade matched online. I love Way and all of their hair products. I had to get this. Comes with a full size of the detox shampoo and a full size of the leave-in conditioner. Two of my favorite products from the brand. This was an impulse purchase. This is the Peter Thomas Roth Gift of Bright Eyes set. This is basically all of the under eye patches. That was so unnecessary. And then I got this Sephora shadow crayon, I think. It's literally so pretty. This is in the shade Rose Gold. I'm so excited to use all these products. Bye.
Christmas. This is a massive Sephora.
Can't talk about the price of everything because it's so relevant.
Okay, so the first thing I got was the Glow Recipe Watermelon Dewdrops. I'm not a Watermelon Dewdrops fan, but this was like on sale because they have like this huge sale. This is what they look like. It's Glow Recipe, guys. It's just a new packaging they have. That's why it like looks like watermelon, and that's why it says IBCCCCCNDC. Glow Recipe. Then I got the Bubble Slam Dunk Moisturizer. Now, I did not know that Sephora sold bubble, but apparently they do. The white thing off because I'm pretty sure that's what you're supposed to do. I got the Glow Recipe Toner, which I'm going to call Ordinary Out because this serum made my whole entire forehead burn. My skin is burned off because of the serum. This is not a good serum. So we all have different skin types, like different like combination, oily. Now I'm not no dermatologist, but do not use this because it literally made my skin burn, like mainly on my forehead, not really on my cheeks. Next up, I got the Dior lip oil. $40 lip oil is insane. So hopefully it's, bro, it's like stuck in the packaging. Let's try it. It smells like mint. I think I'm gonna return it. Okay, so obviously this stuff wasn't from Sephora except this, but in all seriousness, I did actually order something from Sephora. I got the Glow Recipe with Skin Dreams Kit. Only thing I use, like after I cleanse my face, I put this on, and then in the morning I use this. And one of my favorite TikTokers, her name's Sophia. Y'all should go follow her. Videos are like really good, and she deserves more followers. This is what the drops look like. Little pump serum looks like. It's like a glass bottle. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be a strawberry seed shape, and this is what the pump looks like. So yeah, I'll be posting a get ready with me for basketball tryouts tomorrow.
Hi guys, I have a Sephora haul. I don't have a Sephora where I live, so I went all out when I was in London. Starting off with this Sol de Janeiro 71. It's literally so underrated. Like, it literally smells like a baked good. Oh my. We need to spray it on. Oh, it smells so good. It literally smells like the Pink Sugar Summer Fridays lip balm. Then I got another shade of the Summer Fridays lip balm, but this time in vanilla beige. Like, these are literally my holy grail lip balms. And this one smells like a really nice vanilla. Then I got quite a bit of Fenty Beauty, starting off with the Diamond Balm. It's always sold out online, so when I saw it in the store, I knew I had to get it. So the packaging is literally stunning. It has glitters on it. And then I'm going to swatch it for you guys. Oh my, look at that. I also got the famous Madison Beer blush she used in the Vogue Beauty Seekers video. It's actually a highlighter, but it's actually stunning. I'm going to use it as a glowy blush, and it's in the shade Ginger Binge and Moscow Mule. And then I had to get one of their glosses, so I got it in the shade Fussy. It's a classic and a gorgeous pink. Let's apply some. I also got a mini of the Rare Beauty mascara to try out. It's a small one. And this is what the wand looks like. I always wanted to try out a pink powder, so I got the mini size of the Huda Beauty one. And I already have the big one in the shade Cupcake, so I know I love this formula. I also got the Kosas The Wet Undressed set. It comes with the wet stick and the lip oil. And I swatched the lip oil and the lip balm in the store, and I actually really liked it. It's really good value. This is what the lip balm looks like, or like tinted lipstick. I don't know, sheer lipstick, I don't know. And this is what the mini lip oil looks like. It's so freaking cute, and the shade looks really pretty. And the last thing that I got is this Lancome concealer. It's in the shade 3. I've heard very good things about it, like it's very full coverage and stuff like that. But I tried it on already, and I have it on today, and it's so nice. It's not drying at all. It's quite hydrating. It leaves like a little bit of a satin finish. It's really nice. This is all the makeup I picked up from Sephora. I hope you guys liked it. Bye.
Can't stop, won't stop. Someone please just come control me. 3 minutes is probably not going to be enough. And it doesn't even include my online orders. All right, I saw one video, only one video, and that's all it took for me to almost buy every single Makeup by Mario brush. I have so many brushes, and I don't really need this, but I don't know. Their makeup application just looks so amazing. I went ahead and just felt heavily influenced by TikTok. I got the F2 brush, and I also got the F1. And I also ordered like the foundation brush, but that was one of my online orders. These do feel very, very luxe. Next up, I got a Voluspa candle. This one's a Barbados and grapefruit one. It smells absolutely amazing. These actually last me a while, so I'm actually considering buying these. Next, I got the Sol de Janeiro Real Radiance. This one smells so good. I don't really like most of their scents because they smell super sweet, but this one smells very fresh, and I love that. I also got the Makeup by Mario Moisture Glow, Plumping Lip Glow, whatever. I really liked it. It looks great, but I will say I saw on TikTok that these are kind of tiny for the price, and I do agree with that, so I'm not sure if I'm going to return it. Next up, I got the Sowasu, I don't know, Dental Cleansing Oil. I've already been using it, and I am a huge fan. Crown Affair has been all over my For You page lately, and everybody has been recommending it, and since I love using leave-in so much, I got their leave-in, and honestly, it's like 10 out of 10 for the packaging. I will update you guys on this. I got this Beauty Blender Power Pocket Puff. I see everybody on here use it, and I wanted one too. I got this Sephora like little eye massager thing, and like I just thought it looked cool. It was only 10 bucks, you know, whatever. Had to have it. You guys know I love Tower 28, so when I saw like this like two full-size duo, I had to have this. It brings a full-size balm and lipstick, and these are just like my absolute favorite, both of them, so you know, it's a no-brainer. Okay, a few more, bear with me. So I got the Westman Atelier Vitals Skincare Complexion Drops. I'm probably going to be returning this because I did like the finish, and I did like how like it looked on, but it just smells so strong, and I know it's probably skincare, which is like good, but I cannot handle the smell. Rare Beauty blush in the shade Warth, because, you know, we just had to expand our Rare Beauty collection. Summer Fridays sheer skin tint in the shade Light. I also see this all over my For You page and people rave about it, so I had to have it. I got this House Lab highlighter because I saw it on TikTok. It's a little exotic, but I'm gonna try it as a blush topper. I also got two more Westman Atelier blushes to add to my collection. I am so hooked on these. I love them so much. I know they look the same, but they're not.
Gorgeous, gorgeous girls always over blush. Gorgeous, gorgeous girls are always in a rush.
Not one, not two, but three Sephora packages. So let's do a haul of what I bought at the Sephora savings event. Let's start off with the big one first. Okay, starting off, I got the duo pack of the Charlotte Tilbury setting spray. This is my favorite setting spray ever. Laneige lip sleeping mask in caramel apple. I love collecting all the different flavors of these. This is a pair of lashes from Ardell at Sephora, and it comes with a lash glue. I'm really looking forward to these. This is the In Beauty Glaze for Days lip set, and these are such good lip oils if you haven't tried them out yet. I got this pack of the Wow Dream Coats. It comes with a full size and a mini in Chris Appleton We Trust. I'm so excited for this too. This is the Patrick Ta foundation. This was pricey, but it looks gorge on everyone's skin that I see on TikTok. I got two of these Summer Fridays pink sugar lip balms, one for me, one for my sister. If you haven't tried these, try them. They smell so good. This is for my sister. This is the Summer Fridays jet lag mask. I got the Laneige lip balm in the scent peppermint. Literally smells so fresh and so yummy. I got the Sephora collection crayon. This is in like a silver shade. And then my sister got me to pick her this up. This is the Way Better Together shampoo and leave-in conditioner set. First box empty. Number two. I completely forgot I got this. This is a Sephora collection glitter gel liner in like a gold shade. Another one of those crayons, but in rose gold from the Sephora collection. I got a full size of the Glow Recipe toner. I have a mini of this and I've really been loving it, so I was like, might as well splurge on the big one. This I got as a gift for my friend's birthday coming up. It comes with like the 5 mini mascaras, and then you get a voucher for a full size one from Sephora Favorites. And then I got a mini of the Kika pair. I don't know how to say it. This is the Dr. Jar like color correcting treatment. It's definitely a little small for $30, but I wanted to try it and see if it's good at all. Box number two empty. Now the items in here, I bought these like 2 days before the sale went on because they were sold out online and I didn't want to risk not getting them. So this is the Say Mini Dew Blush Trio. I really wanted to try this new shade here. I love these blushes, they're so good. And then lastly, I got the Patrick Ta Headliner Lip Gloss. This was a limited edition shade, so I didn't want to not get it because I didn't know if they were going to put it back in stock or not. So I'm glad I got it before the sale, even if I didn't get a discount. And just like that, the bag is empty. Our haul is over. I feel like I got way more stuff than I actually did, but it's just because it's so pricey that I'm like, where did all my money go? But it's fine. I love Sephora. I love splurging on myself. Treat yourself. Go get something from the sale before it's over.
Hi. I went shopping. Okay, so before we dive in, here is the story. Typically, I am much, much tanner than this, okay? I used to have a natural tan when I was a young girl, right? Because I was always in the sun, soaking up that vitamin D. As I've gotten older, I do sunless tanning and spray tanning, right? Well, now, long story short, I'm in California. I'm kind of stuck here. Not really. I was only planning on being here for like 4 or 5 days, but my trip got extended, and now I've been here for like almost 2 weeks at this point, and I have not spray tanned, sunless tanned, none of the things. So I am fair and pale as shit. Like, look at that. The difference in shade on my underarm, it's weird. So basically I did not have any makeup that matched me whatsoever. So I had to go to Sephora and get all new makeup that would match my skin tone. So I figured we'd do a haul together. So I just got my nails done and I'm obsessed with the color. Okay, so the Sephora store that's next to where I'm staying is a really small store. There's my receipt. So I had to make do with what they had there, right? Like typically my favorite foundation right now is the Tom Ford Stick Foundation. That's not sold out of Sephora or Ulta. So I had to kind of make do with what they had in stock. All right. So first thing, I got the House Labs Foundation. I actually think this might be my first time using it. I used it today and I mixed it with the Charlotte Tilbury. Listen here, okay? I know people are obsessed. They're obsessed. I am not obsessed with this foundation, but I did actually like it today. I don't know. I don't make sense in my own head sometimes, so I'm sure you guys can't make sense of me. But I've tried this before and I've never liked it, but today, mixing it with this, it did take a little work, but it was good. Also, can I just say, Gaga, Miss Gaga, I really appreciate you because her shade range for fair skin is so on point. It is so on point. And if you guys don't think that I'm fair, let me just hold up the arms again. I'm only like the third shade in her shade range. Like, I'm really, really fair right now. And the reason why is because I decided years ago to stop going in the sun. And if I do, I wear a very, very high SPF / sunblock because I don't want any more skin damage. So I am just fair. Okay, I got two cream bronzers because I've been super into cream bronzers recently. I got the Charlotte Tilbury right here. I use the shade number 2 typically, but now I'm shade number 1. It's funny because a couple months ago I talked shit about the shade because I was like, it's so gray. But now that I'm Casper, it looks great. I still don't know how to say the name of this brand. I can't believe myself. Sai? I'm not sure. Again, obsessed. I actually mixed these two together on my face today. Like, I think that these two right here are like the best formulas in the industry for cream bronzers. And the shades together were, I mean, they're giving. House Labs bronzer, this is shade 4. I did not know that House Labs is all clean. I had no clue, which is like so exciting. I feel like so many amazing brands have been completely clean recently and they have pigment, which you could not find in the past, right? So this is exciting. It's kind of making me want to be a clean girly. I'm not committing to that. Don't hold me to that. I got the Dior concealer. This is one of my favorite concealers right now, along with Hourglass. I got it in 2 different shades because I didn't know which shade I would be. I am 0. That's my shade. I also got the Hourglass concealers because, again, I love them. I got them in shade Cotton and Cream. These are my 2 favorite concealers right now. Tried the House Labs. I liked it, but I still was not obsessed with it like I am with these two. These are my favorite. Actually couldn't believe that this was in stock. This is the Rosy Glow 001 Pink Dior Blush right there. Nice blue undertone pink blush. Always looks great on pale ass skin. Oh, I haven't tried this yet. This is the Glow Sculpt Multi-Use Cream Highlighter Blush. This looks so pretty, but I haven't actually used it. Should I put it on my cheeks right now? You want to do it? Okay, hold on. I'm scared. What if I hate it? I have plans tonight. Okay, I'm just going to do it. Oh, shit. Okay. I mean, this is like really pigmented and really beautiful. That's really pretty. This is the Perfection Complexion Stick. Perfecting Complexion Stick. Wow, they missed it with that one. It could have been Perfection Collection Stick. Perfection Complexion? The Perfection Complexion Collection. That is yellow as shit. Okay, see, this is why you don't make like quick last minute decisions when you're running for the register. My friend was already at the register and I like panicked and bought these. I've seen good things about these and I'm pretty sure this brand is clean. Okay, what was I doing? What was I doing? This is not gonna match me. Look at that. Okay, it was definitely a panic move, okay? I'm gonna just put these back in the box and exchange those for my color. I also got the House Labs concealer brush because I hadn't seen this yet and I think it looks like such a nice concealer brush. So I'm very interested in her. So picked her up. And last but not least, got this Sai Glowy Super Gel Dewy Illuminating Fluid. I've heard that this is like very similar to the Drunk Elephant drops. And I have not tried. And I'm pretty sure this brand is clean. My friend who I was shopping with yesterday, she's a clean bitch. And so she's like trying to force me to do everything clean. So I'm pretty sure that this is that. I'll be honest, you guys. I'm not sure how I would use this with fair skin. Because, well, this is lovely. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little color.
I miss being tan.
Okay, you guys, that's it. What do you think about me embracing this fair skin with a snot rocket on my shirt? I think I'm going to keep it up for a while and adjust to it, but don't get it twisted. I'm going to be a tan girly for life. All right, let me know if you want my tanning routine. Bye. Let's be singing, let's be jolly, deck the halls with boughs of holly.
you are placing an order on Sephora's website in the near future at all, you are going to want to know this. We all know that you get like 2 free trial samples with every Sephora online purchase, but I bet you didn't know that there are so many more free samples that you could be receiving without having to be checking all of those like marketing emails with codes. In my most recent order, all I got was this travel size of the Fenty perfume. It's a purse spray. I think it was like $39 and then tax, but they have an entire section on the Sephora app called offers, and I was looking around in there and I saw one for their like September hair trial sizes, and this was free. Like, this offer was free as long as I think you spent $30 on the website or $35 on the website. And look at how many things I got. When I opened up my package and I saw that this was the hair sampler, I was shook. Like, this has so many amazing products in it, and they are like deluxe sample sizes that you would buy in the checkout. In this pack alone, I got an Amika Perk Up Dry Shampoo, Crown Affair Leave-In Conditioner Deluxe Sample Size, a Bumble and Bumble Hairdresser's Invisible Oil Primer, Shu Uemura Hair Oil, and the Living Proof Triple Bond Complex. And then a bunch of these packet samples from amazing brands, like this is the Day Shampoo and Conditioner, 2 of the Moroccan Oil Hand Creams, an Orbe Shampoo and Conditioner Duo, and 2 samples of the Kérastase Hair Oil, which I already use and love. I literally got this entire bag of deluxe size, really nice hair samples, plus my 2 regular samples that I always pick at checkout, all for just buying the travel size perfume that I was already planning to buy. And I went back on the app today, and these deals are always changing, so they didn't have this exact same September hair sample bag, but they have like a La Mer sample, a bunch of Chanel samples for fragrance and beauty. They just have so many good things. I feel like people don't know about this.
We just went to Sephora, and I went for one thing. I ended up spending almost $400, so I'm gonna show you everything I got. What I went for is this Youth to the People Superberry Hydrate and Glow Dream Mask. I've been using this for like 3 years. If you have dry skin, I use this every night for like my night cream. And also sometimes when I have really dry skin in the morning, I'll use it in the morning. Unbelievable. And then I layer it with their, this is like the same thing, but it's in an oil. Then I was out of this. I got sent this a long time ago and it was unbelievable. You're supposed to change your mascara like every 3 months, and I'm trying to be better about that. So this is my favorite mascara right now. I realized about myself, I just like a brown mascara. This is my favorite primer in the world. I'm like so into Charlotte Tilbury right now, like everything. This Wonder Glow primer, I will wear this like every day, just like without anything else even, if I just want a little glowy look and it makes your skin look so pretty. It's crazy. Celia was like, you really have never used Pillow Talk before? But I've never used Pillow Talk, so I'm gonna use it for the first time right now. Obviously, I've heard great things about it, but I've never, wow. It does glide on really nice, huh?
And I can't believe this is your first time.
I've been meaning to get it. It's just, I don't know. And then I'm so excited about this. I've seen everyone with the Summer Fridays lip balms, like every time I open TikTok, someone has them. So I got this little trio. I do not need any more lip gloss. I have so much lip gloss, but it's my favorite thing. I'm gonna smell all of them. Okay. Vanilla Delish.
Are they tinted?
I don't know. I kind of hope not. Oh, excuse me. Oh, they are tinted.
I was caused you to swear.
Her iced coffee one. Celia's dying to smell it too. So, wow. Smell?
Wow.
Is it tinted? It's like a little tinted.
Huh. It actually looks nice with the Pillow Talk though. I feel like the cherry would look nice with the Pillow Talk.
Mmm, this is delicious.
You guys asked, so I'm going to deliver. Let me show you everything I bought at Sephora. So I am kind of starting to get into my makeup girly era just because I'm just not a makeup wearer. I've got a filter on right now, but I typically don't wear makeup except for SPF and maybe a little bit of mascara, but I'm just not a makeup girly. So I have decided, after watching everybody on TikTok try some of these products, I was gonna try some too and see if I liked it. Okay, so I'm just gonna rapid fire these. So I got the Summer Fridays Jet Lag Mask. I have seen it so many times from people over the years. I decided to get it in like the travel size to see if I even like it before I invest in the big size, so I got that. My friend, Hello Amanda, she recommended this Say Slip Tint. It is a SPF 35 tinted moisturizer, so I got that. I got 4.5, the color. The 5 looked good, I think, if it was like midsummer. But 4.5, I think, is going to be my baseline. Let's see. I also got the Fenty Beauty Eavesdrop Blurring Skin Tint. It looked pretty good. I got the shade 14. Let's see. Sorry about my kid is in the back. He's listening to videos. So I tried this last night, so it's already opened. But I got the Ordinary Multipeptide Lash and Brow Serum. I've considered getting Latisse, but I haven't like made the jump yet. Let's see here. Here's the Ordinary Serum. And then I got the Urban Decay All Nighter Long Lasting Makeup Setting Spray. This one I think is supposed to be more glowy than the other ones, but it's 16-hour wear and it's transfer proof. And that's the problem I'm really having lately, is that because I don't normally wear makeup, I'm not applying it, I guess, to where it doesn't get all over everything all the time. So there's that. And then I got a bunch of Makeup by Mario stuff. So I got this Master Blade Brow Pencil. I also, let me just dig all of this out. And then I got a Moisture Grow Plumping Lip Serum. Not that I need any type of plumping, I just really liked the color of this. I also got this Surreal Skin Awakening Concealer. I needed a new concealer. I was using a NARS concealer sample that I got, and that has runneth dry. And then the last thing that I got for makeup was this Masterhold Brow Gel. I figured like this would be really good for days that I don't want to like do my brows. I mean, they're not in like terrible shape or anything, but. And then this is the whole reason why I went to Sephora, is for the ColourWell Dream Coat Extra Strength. I just finished my bottle of regular strength Dream Coat. So I ran there to get the extra strength because, as you guys know, I have type 3C hair and I live in Florida. So I'm going to try this out and give you guys a full testimony. But yeah, that's everything that I got at Sephora yesterday. I have something super exciting happening to me tomorrow. I can't announce it yet, but when I can, I will show you. And that is the whole reason why I decided to go full Monty into getting some things that I might be able to wear. But I will definitely try some of this stuff on, let you guys know how I like it, if I don't like it. Again, coming from the perspective of a non-makeup girly. So I'll let you guys know. Have a good day.
I just went to Sephora, so let's do a Sephora haul, makeup haul. So I really have been wanting to try the Summer Fridays lip products, and I've been looking. I wanted to buy them online because I saw that Sephora came out with like the 3-pack, but it said online only, and I decided today that I really, really wanted to try it. So I was gonna go in store and just buy one. When I got there, they had mint in stock, which said online only. They had the 3-pack, very last one. I'm so excited for this one and this one. I also got Bright Future. It's just the Sephora concealer. This is the Fenty Beauty Eavesdrops, the Blurring Skin Tint. Just because I've been wanting a skin tint. Let's see. I have to try it on tomorrow, like, without makeup on. Okay, let's try out mint. The color is so pretty. It smells so good. I'm a mint girl. Okay, cute. I love. Also came with a jet lag mask. I did accidentally taste the mint one, and it does taste good. Now we're gonna try iced coffee. I'm pretty sure this is the one that's new that just came out. You can't buy it individually. Oh my gosh. That smells so good. It smells like caramel iced coffee, or kind of like butterscotch. Color. This smells really good. Doesn't really taste like anything. I love. This is vanilla. This one's clear. Cute. Just like a clear gloss. I love it though. I saved this one for last because I'm so excited for this color. This is the color cherry. I don't know if you guys saw the video, probably because I think it was super popular, but a girl was saying that this is the perfect like date night shade. So She looks so good. Let's try. Ooh, I love. Like, this is not too dark. This one's really, really good, and it smells good. Someone said they taste good. Mine don't taste like anything, but I'm obsessed. From having zero to having four all in one day, I can't help it. I would recommend all of them. They smell delicious, and I think the tints are perfect. Love this one. These two are more clear, and this is just like the perfect tint without being too much. So